Good morning, students. Students, in our previous lecture, I explained to you what are alcohols, aromatic alcohols, and phenols. Student, as you know, the name of the chapter is alcohol, phenol, and ether. So today I'll try to explain to you what are ethers and try to discuss something ahead of that also. So when I talk about the ethers, ethers are those class of a compound in which oxygen atom is linked to two alkyl groups. So when we talk about the ethers, they are the class of compounds in which oxygen is linked to two alkyl groups. So ethers, these are class of compounds. Ethers are the class of compounds in which oxygen atom is linked to two alkyl group. In which oxygen atom is linked to two alkyl group. Is linked to two alkyl groups. Am I clear? Now, these alkyl group may be same or they may be different. If someone asks you what will be the general formula for ether, general formula for ether is CN H2N plus 2 and O. Am I getting clear, student? CN H2N plus 2 and O. Now these ethers, they can be classified into two categories. This will either be the symmetrical ether or unsymmetrical ethers. So ethers are broadly classified into two categories. These are symmetrical ethers. Symmetrical ethers are represented as ROR. And unsymmetrical ether. Symmetrical ethers and unsymmetrical ethers. These are written as ROR dash. Student, when I talk about the symmetrical ether, here two alkyl groups are same. So two alkyl groups are same. And when we talk about the unsymmetrical ether, here the two alkyl groups are different. Two alkyl groups are different. So alkyl groups are same or the alkyl groups are different. Just see this example. Like this one, CH3, O and CH3. You may see over here, to the oxygen atom, the two alkyl groups are attached and both these alkyl groups are same. So this will be called as symmetrical ether. How shall I name this one? For one carbon atom, the root word is methane and this is alkoxy group. So name of this group will be given as methoxymethane. Or we may easily call it as, these are methyl group and this is ether. So this is dimethyl ether. Am I clear? Similarly, if suppose we take this compound CH3, CH2 and then O, then again CH2 and CH3. Here again you may see, student, both the alkyl groups are same. So this will be what? Ethane. This is what group? Ethoxy. So name of this group will be given as ethoxyethane. Is it clear? Now when we talk about the unsymmetrical ether, unsymmetrical ethers are those ethers in which the two different alkyl groups are attached to the oxygen atom. Like if we take this one, CH3 and then CH2 and then O and then CH2 and CH3. Student, this ethoxyethane, if I want to give you the common name of this, the common name of this will be diethyl ether. This is diethyl ether. Here, this is CH3, CH2, and then O and CH3. Here the alkyl groups are different. So this will be 1, this will be 2. This is what group? Ethane. This is what group? Methoxy. So the name of this group will be given as methoxyethane. Here the two alkyl group attached to the oxygen atom are different. Am I clear? Or this is ethyl, this is methyl. So this will be ethyl methyl ether. Common name of this will be given as ethyl, and then methyl, and then ether. So what will be the common name of this? It will be ethyl methyl ether. Am I clear? Just see this one over here, student. So important point is that the two alkyl group attached to the oxygen atom are different. Suppose if you take this one, CH3, and then CH, and then CH3, and then O, and then CH2, and then CH3. We want to give a name to this one. This will be 1, 2, 3. The name of this group will be given as 2-ethoxypropane. This is 2-ethoxy. And this over here will be propane. Otherwise, in the common name system, this is isopropyl and this is ethyl. So what name shall we give to this one? This is ethyl isopropyl ether. Ethyl isopropyl ether. Am I clear? So symmetrical and unsymmetrical ether must be very, very clear to you. Students, apart from symmetrical and unsymmetrical ether, we have in our syllabus the aromatic ethers. Now, aromatic ethers. The two aromatic ethers you must remember. Aromatic ethers. In aromatic ethers, how do we represent them? This is an aromatic group which normally will be benzene, and then we have oxygen, and then this will be R. These are aromatic ethers. As for example, if you consider this group, this is a benzene ring. And over here, we write down CH3. Yes? So what name shall be given to this one? This is methoxybenzene. Or otherwise, you must remember this by the name of anisole. This is a special name of this. Similarly, if you take this one, this is O. CH2, CH3. What name shall we give to this one? This is ethoxybenzene. Or we may call it as phenytol. Am I clear? Similarly, if you write down this structure. Suppose the structure over here is this one. This is phenoxy group and benzene. So what name shall we give to this one? This is phenoxybenzene. Or we may call it as diphenyl ether. So we have a phenoxybenzene, or we may call it as diphenyl ether. Am I clear? So this is how, or this is something about the brief introduction of ether. So student, in this chapter, we'll be discussing about alcohols, we'll be discussing about phenols, and we'll be discussing about ethers. As far as ethers are concerned, ether will be having a general formula CnH2n+2O. Is it clear to all of you? They can be symmetrical or they can be the unsymmetrical ethers. Is it clear? Now, before we start discussing further, I'll try